We've had a very strong leading edge conversation, much as what you ask for. You ask, are there any words that are a vibrational match to what's in the vortex? And that is the stream of words that we just gave to you. In some cases, you weren't ready for them and they were annoying. In some cases, you were ready for them and it was enlivening. In every case, they were new for you, and so it was a little bit unsettling. That's what trying to turn it into words before you're ready for it accomplishes. That's the demonstration that we were wanting to offer here. Words don't teach. It's life experience that brings you your knowing. And the life experience that comes to you, the knowing that it brings, is a really simple understanding. This that's happening to me right here, right now, no matter what this occasion is, no matter who you're interacting with, this experience that's happening right now and how I feel about it is a simple byproduct of my relationship with my vortex, period. That's all that it is. And you have the potential of putting yourself in vibrational harmony with your vortex in a much more consistent way than you have formerly known. Do we want you to bridge beliefs? Not really. Bridging beliefs is not really an exercise that we are really wanting you to work really hard about. Because we understand that the natural laws of the universe, the natural processes of being part of this physical experience, will cause an evolution of all that you are. And we know for sure that you cannot continue to move forward in time as you do, as you come into this body and the next and the next. It's not possible for you to hold as a collective consciousness or as an individual to beliefs, because life will continue to show you more, 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 more. You know what beliefs really are? We're just savoring it for a little while. Beliefs are your observation through your physical senses of what is. Desires are your observation through your non-physical senses of what is becoming.
Yes. My future self. Yes. Yes. Yes.
So it's necessary to be willing to relax and release the what is in order to enjoy what is becoming. And since you're a creator, you gotta be in the mode of becoming, or you're not gonna feel good. We have enjoyed this interaction immensely. There's gonna be a few days before we are returning to this gathering. So this is your homework. We usually do not offer suggestions about homework. But since this is your home, this is your work for the next few days. Ask yourself every chance you get, is this what I mean to broadcast? Is this what I mean to broadcast? Is this what I'm wanting to practice into reality? Is this practicing of this thought? Does it feel good here and now? And do I want an amplification of this feeling? Do I want this feeling to flesh out into more fullness? Do I want to involve more others in this expansion of this feeling? And it is our expectation that as a result of this conversation that you are right up to speed with. It took some doing, but you did it. You're right up to speed with it. It is our expectation that in the days that unfold, you will, for the first time in your human experience this time around, be a pure extension of the source energy that is you. And when you dance together with others who are doing the same, it's going to be a celebration unlike any birthday party you've ever experienced. There is great love here for you. And as always, we remain in the vortex. Good. Good morning. We are extremely pleased that you are here. It is good to come together for the purpose of co-creating. Do you agree? You're knowing what you are wanting. You're enjoying the expansion of your personal desire. You like being in the receiving mode and finding your desire. You like recognizing that often that's when your strongest, clearest, most important desires occur to you, because they've been all mixed together in your vortex, yes? And now you are in a vibrational place where you can feel a fuller version of them, a sort of gathered version of them, a version of them that is moving strong enough with enough momentum that it is a thought that you can receive. Don't you like knowing that? Can you feel the difference in the way you now feel about your own desire than you may have before? That desire is a strong indication that what's in your vortex is coming into actuality, and it's coming strong enough that it's actually occurring to you in vivid form. And have you been feeling that when that desire occurs, enough that you want to speak it almost breathlessly because of your enthusiasm for your discovery of it, that now your work is to promote that desire, to keep it feeling fresh like that, to not contradict it with the practical version of it or the already manifested version of it? Isn't it logical that you would be inspired to the reception of a new desire that goes beyond what you've manifested before? It's beyond what is manifested, and therefore most likely beyond what you believe, because if you already believed it, it would already be manifested. So it's a desire that you don't yet quite believe. Can you find a way to keep the belief from hindering the desire, or modifying the belief so that it matches the desire? If you can do that, then you can do anything, because your life is going to continue to keep you moving forward. And your vortex is going to continue to be the beginning of your full manifestation of anything that you desire. There is nothing that you cannot be or do or have. Nothing is off limits, and there is nothing that you are incapable of. It's just a matter of understanding the process, understanding the laws of the universe, understanding how it works, and understanding the importance of the fact that you received a desire. So when you receive it, don't kill it, not right away. And don't talk to others about it who aren't up to speed with you. Don't ask them what they think. Don't ask them for their opinion. Don't ask them even for their support in it, because they weren't there necessarily with you when you were in the receptive mode and you got it. This is a private thing for you, a private thing for you to continue to nurture all the way out to its fulfillment. Not something that needs support from physical beings who may or may not be there, but something that is getting, that now exists in the full support of non-physical energy, the energy that creates worlds. It's flowing through you, and that's why you even know that you have a desire. Thoughts are turning to things right before your eyes, and you have a front row seat to watching this cooperative universe assist you in enjoying the evolution, the expansion, and the see it, hear it, smell it, taste it full version of whatever it is that you are wanting. We're eager to visit with you about whatever matters to you. What is it now? What is it now? What is it now? Yeah.